My name is Paul Grine. I am in grade 7 at St. Peter's and St. Paul's School in Durham. I made a video about one of my political heroes, John George Diefenbaker, Canada's 13th Prime Minister. I'm here with Canada's 22nd and current Prime Minister, Stephen Harper, to talk about the legacy of Prime Minister Diefenbaker. Prime Minister, thank you for being here.
Great. Well, thank you for having me, Paul. I've been looking forward to this.
At 8 years of age, Diefenbaker told his mother that someday he would become Prime Minister. It would seem unlikely for a rural boy to achieve such a great dream, but he did. What does that say about Diefenbaker and about Canada?
Look, I think it says a lot about both. First of all, John Diefenbaker was obviously a person of tremendous determination. He didn't just come from rural Canada, he came from an immigrant background. He was way outside what was then the mainstream of our society, and he tried, you probably know Paul, he tried many times to get elected, to lead parties, with a lot of failures along the way, and managed at the later part of his career to not only lead the National Conservative Party, but go on all the way to become Prime Minister. So I think it speaks tremendously about the obvious determination that this individual had and a vision that he was determined to see through. It also says a great deal about our country. There are very few countries in the world where people like, from a background like John Diefenbaker, even my background, where people could really aspire and actually come to the highest office in the land without having powerful friends, without having, being dependent on a lot of backers. So, I think it speaks tremendously for the kinds of opportunity we have in our country, not just in politics, but in every walk of life.
What do you admire most about John Diefenbaker?
You know, a lot of people believe, for reasons that kind of escape me, that I've modeled myself after John Diefenbaker. I think we're very different people with very different styles, and I never actually met Mr. Diefenbaker. He ceased to be Prime Minister when I was only 4 years old, so I don't remember him as Prime Minister. I remember sort of the later part of his political career when we had other Prime Ministers, but I would say the one big commonality between our two governments, and something I certainly admire, is the emphasis he put on the Canadian North. He was the first Prime Minister of Canada to actually set foot above the Arctic Circle, to really go to our northernmost territories. And he had a very ambitious program of building roads and of linking the country to the resources and the potential of Canada's Arctic. And that's something our government in its own way has been very proud to pursue.
As Prime Minister, Diefenbaker had many accomplishments, including the Bill of Rights, appointing the first female cabinet minister, and extending the vote to First Nations. What do you think was Diefenbaker's biggest accomplishment?
You know, Paul, I would say that the list you just gave really is the core of Diefenbaker's most important accomplishment. The most important thing about John Diefenbaker, I think to this day, is he was the first and remains the only Prime Minister we have had who was not of British or French background. And you know, we're in a country where increasingly we have people from backgrounds all over the world, not just our Aboriginal, British and French traditional Canadians. And he was the first person to achieve the highest office in the land, and it was reflective of many of the things he did. I think he was the first Prime Minister to really make multiculturalism, our ethnic diversity, a reality in our life. You talked about some of the things he did in terms of advancing women, advancing Aboriginal people. But more than anything, I think he'll be most remembered for the Bill of Rights. Diefenbaker brought in the first codified rights in our country, and he did it over 20 years before the present day charter. And I think that's the thing he'll be most remembered for. We've been funding, helping to create the Canadian Museum of Human Rights in Winnipeg. And every time I've spoken about that, I've really talked about John Diefenbaker's Prime Ministership as the inspiration for our Canadian vision of human rights.
Mr. Diefenbaker was born in Neustadt in Grey County, where I'm from. In fact, my great-great-grandfather used to own the house on Barber Street where Diefenbaker was born. One thing with history is that if you don't record or preserve it, it is easily forgotten. And the house in Neustadt is a little like that. The residents for years have tried to protect their national and local heritage. Is there any way you can help preserve this important part of our heritage?
Well, there certainly is, but first of all, let me just say that you know a little bit about this. We've talked about this. I know the house very well. My mother was born and raised in Grey County, and my grandparents lived in Hanover, not far from Neustadt, the last few years of their lives. And in fact, I can tell you, I jogged through Neustadt and jogged past that house more than once as a teenager, so I know exactly where it is. And it's a very, very humble home, which would reflect the kind of origin of John Diefenbaker that we're talking about. And I didn't know until recently your great-grandfather had owned it. What we're going to do, as you know, is we're going to arrange to acquire that property and run it as a National Historic Site through Parks Canada. So we'll help preserve that part of John Diefenbaker's legacy. It's in addition to other things we're doing. We already maintain a Diefenbaker Center that really focuses on his years as Prime Minister at the University of Saskatchewan. But look, I think this will be a great addition to see the very humble rural background that this man grew up in. And I'm glad your family has preserved it for so many years, and we look forward to the Government of Canada doing that in the future.
Thank you, Prime Minister Harper. It is great to know that the Diefenbaker's house will be properly restored and commemorated. Thank you for your time, and good luck in the election.
Well, thank you for your interest in our history and all the work you've done on this and that your family's done. And I look forward to seeing where your future career may take you as well, Paul. But thanks for having me.